Matt, are you naked?
We'll never know. I'm definitely, I'm at least not wearing a shirt. Connor, are you almost naked?
I'm at least wearing just an undershirt.
We'll never know which half is covered and which half isn't.
Not.
I could be wearing a tube top.
You know what I forgot to do?
What?
Forgot to change my background for this week. Hold on.
Oh, that's rough, dude.
I know. That's the one from last week. Here, give me a second. Sorry.
It's disappointing. The preparation, man. Like, that's the whole point of this.
I get that. I know I've let you down, but it's only going to take me a second.
Okay.
Let's see. Here we go.
oh, no.
Welcome to this week's episode of the Garlic Boys. We're your welcome to this week's episode of the Garlic Boys podcast, where we treat friendship like a good recipe treats garlic. You can never have too much of it. We're your hosts. I'm Connor O'Connor,
and I'm Duck Van Dyke, the leader of New Ducktonia, and I'd like to welcome you to our town, New Ducktonia.
I would like to welcome y'all to Bald Matt.
Well, they can't actually see, like, they can just see, like, I could have the same haircut, just kind of like push back, because all they can see is the sides here.
I don't know if you look up here, there's no hair dip.
Matt went through a midlife crisis when he was 22 and decided to shave his head. 23. I don't know what age I was.
Matt sent me this photo. Did not tell me he was going to do this. He was coming over, I think, like 2 days after you did this, right?
I think so. Something like that.
And so when he came in, I programmed my Alexa that when I said, "Hey, Alexa, Matt's here," it started playing Shiny from Moana.
I remember that. Oh, Lord.
But before it played it, it went, "Oh my goodness, it's so shiny. Dear God, the shine. It hurts my eyes."
I didn't even shave it shiny. Like, it was just like a very, very short buzz.
You just like took your trimmers and went like no guard on it or anything, just trimmed it down.
Yep.
Which I can't imagine doing at this point in my life.
Your hair is so long at this point. Like, can you imagine, like, I've tried to get to where you are, and it's insanely difficult to get, like, for me personally, to get through that, like the awkward stages in between short and medium long, you know.
That's why I wore my hat so much.
Yeah, I can't wear hats all the time. I just hate wearing hats sometimes. So I've struggled, and to get where you are and then just to shave it all off, I would probably die.
There would have to be a super big reason for me to shave my head. Like
the president of the United States is bald and really, really needs a wig. So you have to cut off your hair to give it. It has to be you specifically. You're the same hair type.
No. I would do it in Practical Jokers, where, like, if I shaved my head and they made it into a wig for you to wear.
Oh, yeah. And then I shave my head and wear the wig. Yeah, that's a great idea.
I would definitely do that.
Well, it's a good thing you've lost two of our quizzes. I think we've done three. It's good thing you've lost two, because when we get to the punishment, I'll make you shave your head.
I've lost one.
We've done three, and you've lost two.
No, we've done two.
I don't remember, because I don't have the card that I wrote all the stuff down on. So,
looks like somebody's not as prepared as they should be.
Yeah. You're not wrong.
What's a real shame is that my hair is about halfway down my back right now.
Yeah.
And so, like, by the time I lose enough quizzes to actually have a punishment, if it does happen,
I haven't been.
It'll probably be way longer, and that's with it being curly. Like,
yeah,
because I don't straighten my hair, so it could be even further down.
It'll be to your butt for sure. Excuse me.
But, so do you want to do the quiz then?
Yeah, I do. I have something very, very well prepared It's definitely not a top 10 list on the internet. It's definitely something I really focused on and tried to create for you.
For those of you that are confused, Matt was horrible at last week's quiz. Did not get a single
question. Don't listen to last week's episode. Just
and so to prove that it's not that hard to win a quiz, I challenged Matt to give me a quiz, and he was able to make it as hard or as easy as he wanted to. And so, Matt, what have you got for me?
The name of my quiz this week is We All Live in a Yellow Submarine. That's the name of my quiz this week.
Is it anything to do with the Beatles?
Not even remotely. It's a ocean theme. It's okay. An ocean theme. You know, world events have led me to this point. World events that we discussed we wouldn't talk about in case, you know, something bad happens. So it's not about submarines or anything. It is about the ocean. Question one. I'm just going to jump right in there.
Jump right into it. Let's do this.
Question one. Exactly. And I mean exactly. How much of the ocean covers the Earth? Percentage-wise. You don't have to do like 60 million gallons. I just need percentage.
I'm 70 and 72 are popping into my head.
This is as of 2022, by the way. This is when this article was written that I got the questions off.
I'm going to just take the average and say 71%.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
You are incredibly lucky. It is 71%. You said between 70 and 72. I was hoping you'd just pick one of those. But you did the average, unfortunately, which is 71% of the Earth's surface. It's probably more at this point, if I'm being honest, because... you know, ice melting and polar caps and all that jazz. Next question.
This is easy. Let's do this.
There are 50 critical minerals on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
How many of them are found in the ocean?
Okay. So the critical minerals, I'm assuming those are like zinc, like those types of things.
Ooh. It is a non-fuel mineral.
A non-fuel mineral.
Or mineral material that is essential to the economic or national security of the U.S. and has the supply chain vulnerable to disruption. That is what a critical mineral is called.
And you said they were found in the ocean?
There are some found in the ocean. 50 total. How many are in the ocean?
Are you referring to in the ocean as in the water or just found with under sea level?
In the ocean.
Okay. Let's go with 38.
Is that your final answer?
That is my final answer.
You are so, so unnervingly close. Like, did you look up this before?
I promise you I didn't. 38 was just the answer that popped in my head.
37.
Ah. My first instinct was to say all 50. Then you said some of them, and I was like, oh, so it's not all 50.
Could have been still. Question number three.
Okay.
The ocean is commonly referred to as analogous version of what human organ?
An analogous version. So it's can be an analogy to an organ.
Correct.
Let's see. The ocean, there's many things within it, things swimming around, many components to it. It's a it's an organ. And so we look through like what is an actual organ. We have the stomach. We have the lungs, gallbladder, the pancreas, the kidneys. There's two. The appendix. I believe the lymphatic system were technically organs.
Don't forget the skin.
Skin, yeah. I'm going to actually go with skin.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah, just because.
That is incorrect. Oh, shoot. You know what? I should have been writing the correct and incorrect. Okay, you got one correct and one incorrect. Well, now two incorrect. Okay. The ocean acts as the Earth's heart. It is a circulatory system for heat and water, all that jazz. I don't know.
Point of order, the heart isn't an organ, it's a muscle.
Well, then that's my bad.
So I get a point back.
Well, I just say you don't get a loss. You don't get it.
I'm at 1-1.
You're at 1-1. I'll give it to you. Okay.
I think it is technically an organ. It's just made out of muscle instead of actually like organic tissue. And so, whatever. But.
Okay. Sounds good. Well, I'll still give you 1-1. True or false? There is enough salt in the ocean to cover the Earth twice.
Oh, that's true, baby.
Is it true? Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
That is false. There is enough salt in the ocean to cover the Earth once. There's not enough to cover the Earth twice.
Wrong.
No.
Nope. You're wrong.
Facts.
False.
Nope. Okay. Approximately how much of the world's ocean has been mapped?
Now, you're saying approximate because they don't have a definite answer for it. But I know that you want me to say what the exact answer is, and I can't just be close to it.
In this case, you can be close to it, but I will judge how close whenever you give me an answer.
My first instinct is to say like 2%. But part of me also feels like it's closer to 15%. The strange thing about the oceans is that we know more about space than we do the oceans. Because wildly, it's easier to explore space. So I'm going to go, I'm going to hedge my bet between 2 and 15 and say 9%.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
Connor, I'll give it to you. Only because it is less than 10%. I was going to say, if you said 9 or 10, I would have given you the answer.
If it's less than 10%, if I said 1 through 10, then...
No, because if it's 9 or less, they'll say less than 9%.
Okay.
Does that make sense? So less than 10% means it's probably like 9.62397, you know, something like that, which isn't exactly 10, but it's easier to say less than 10 than 9.32678. I don't know.
Plus it sounds smaller.
Yeah. True or false?
Can you number these? I don't even know how far into the quiz we are.
This is number 6, but if we took out the 1, then it's number 5. That's number 6.
Number 6.
Yeah. true or false, the ocean floor is stationary.
False.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah, the tectonic plates move, and that's what causes tsunamis.
That's true. I mean, you got it right.
This dude don't even know about tsunamis. Tsunami.
Okay. This is a question I have for you.
Number seven. Come on, I get it. It's not like we do a quiz every week.
The sea level today, or I guess as of 2022,
okay,
is less than it was in 2021.
Is this a true or false?
Is lower. Yeah, it'd be true or false.
It's lower than it was in 2021 and 2022. Well, the sea levels are rising because of climate change. And I think because of the pandemic, there was less boats in the water because of like shipping and things like that. And so I think I'm going to say false.
False, the sea level was not less in 2021. Than in 2022? As in it was higher, I guess, in 2021.
I think it was higher in 2021 than it was in 2022.
Okay.
No. It was higher in 2022 than in 2021.
Okay.
I know. I think I've confused myself now. Oh, no. Ask me the question again.
If I remember the question, I think I said true or false. The sea level, I think what I said was the sea level in 2022 was lower than the sea level in 2021. That's what I said.
It was lower than in 2021. I've confused myself. I'm just going to say true.
It was false.
Dang it.
Sorry. I know that was kind of confusing now that I think about it. I don't care. Holy moly. That's a big number.
Am I wrong about what tsunamis are?
Tsunamis are essentially hurricanes.
Oh, I am. What's the tidal wave?
I don't know. Do you want to look this up?
Big wave of water.
That's the tidal wave.
Is it?
I don't know what causes them.
No, it is a tsunami. But what is the tropical storm seas? Oh, so hurricanes can also be known as cyclones. And I think that's the other name.
Oh, gotcha. All right, I got number eight for you. Comes with a little information, all right?
Okay.
Some studies indicate that there are about 8.7 million eukaryotic species. Eukaryotes are plants, animals, and fungi found on the earth. Okay. There are about 8.7 million. Approximately, and I'll be a little bit lenient on this number, how many are marine?
6.5.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
That is incorrect. The actual answer is approximately 2.2 million. However, the number of species that live in the ocean is unknown. So, but I wouldn't I wouldn't assume that it would be a four million difference. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that's fair.
Okay.
Because I don't know why I thought there was a lot of fish. There's like, oh, there's just tons of stuff down there.
There is a ton of stuff down there, though. And I mean, a lot of it's, again, undiscovered.
Do you think there's more types of birds or more types of fish?
I'd say types of fish. We should find that out. Hey, Connor, a question for you. Are there more types of birds or more types of fish? No, I'm just kidding. Okay, number 9. The Great Lakes. You know, these Great Lakes that are above us are considered to be ocean-like, true or false?
True. Because they got beaches, and the ocean has a beach. it's ocean-like. And also, the lakes like the ocean, and I know that because they wave at each other.
I'll give it to you, sure.
Are they ocean-like? But I'm getting it correct for the wrong reason.
They are ocean-like. It takes actually a lot of similar techniques. They don't have salt as much as the ocean does, but they do take a lot of techniques similar to ocean studying techniques.
The Great Lakes are actually believed to be glaciers that millions of years ago melted and became lakes. And that's why they're so deep. It's because they were actually strong ice structures. I do have an answer.
An answer for the birds and fish?
Yes. This comes from thefisheriesblog.com on a debate called Birds versus Fish. The quote says, numbers of species. It is estimated there is over 28,000 extant species of fish compared to approximately 10,000 extant species of birds.
Okay.
And so there's roughly 18,000 more species of fish than birds.
Okay.
We just pulled the fun facts for y'all this week.
So number 10, the final question. We all know that the Mariana Trench is the deepest point on Earth. But what is the highest point on Earth?
Are you talking about like what reaches highest into the atmosphere? Are you talking about from base to tip, which measures the highest? Because highest into the atmosphere would be Mount Everest, but there is a underwater mountain that is taller than Mount Everest and is the tallest technical mountain in the world. It's just below sea level, and so it doesn't count as the tallest mountain.
I mean, from the center of the Earth's core to the highest point on Earth, what is that point?
I'm going to go with that mountain that's underwater. I don't know the name of it. But if it's the answer, I feel like that's enough to get me the answer, the point.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
I'm going to go with incorrect, although you might be confused. Like, okay, so if we drew a circle, all right, a sphere, and right here is the center of the Earth, the exact center. The ocean is like lower, right? So like a tall mountain in the ocean wouldn't be as high as a mountain on the crust. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but it's taller.
Yeah, but it's not the highest point on the Earth.
But it's taller.
But it's under the water, which Everest is higher than the water.
Why would you ask a question about the, like, why would you do 9 questions about the ocean
Because I was,
and then be like, oh, Everest is the last answer. Ha 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 ha.
The if I would have asked, what's the deepest point on Earth? What would your answer have been?
The Mariana Trench.
You would have known that. So I had to make it a little difficult.
You could have done the tallest mountain on Earth. Because that's a fun ocean fact about the tallest mountain being an underwater mountain.
I could have done that.
You changed the entire identity of the quiz for the last
time. I still related the Mariana Trench being the lowest point. And then I asked what the highest point was. Would you like me to try and find a tiebreaker since you are only 9 questions in?
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. Then it may take me a second.
Take your headphones off for a second.
Why? Oh, he's going to rant about me.
As much as I disapprove of what he just did, I think that was a baller move, and I'm so proud of it. The fact that he even thought to do something like that is impressive. And I don't know if he can hear me right now, and if he can, he's just pretending that he can't. Which is good on him for not giggling at what I'm saying. But what I will tell you is that I'm going to pretend to keep acting because I feel like I justly am. And I would like it if you guys could comment on the video that we post on Instagram or TikTok promoting this episode and tell Matt how upset you are with him for that question as well, because it wasn't fair. And it's only funny when I do it. And that's what we're going to tell him, because he needs to learn he doesn't steal my bits. Also, I'm very thankful for everyone who listens. Matt doesn't like saying this because he's not an emotional person, but I will be telling y'all how grateful I am for you. And now I know Matt is listening because I saw him smile. And it wasn't just because he was smiling at something on his phone. He definitely heard me say his name again. And now he's bending over giggling. Oh no, he's laughing so hard. Dear gosh, I think he's going to choke. Matt, are you okay? Can you hear me? Oh no, I think he's gone. What? Matt, I can't hear you. You have to speak up. Matt, don't go towards the light. Please, come back to us. And then, that is when he'll know my fury has no end, and he will be the last of us.
All right. I have a question for you.
Okay.
Oh, this is a good question too.
Ask do you both want? Of them.
Okay, I'll ask both of them. I'll ask you the first one, and then the second one will be like just a fun extra question. Percent. This is a true or false question. 85% of the Earth's volcanic activity happens in the ocean.
Correct.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
No, it's not.
It's actually 90%.
So if it's 90%, then 85% does happen because it's more than 85%. So I am correct.
Only in the way that...
that matters and counts?
90% is the answer.
Yeah, so 85% is correct.
Yeah, but you could have also said 2%, and that would have been correct as well by your logic.
Yeah.
No, because if you're talking about if I said how much of the Earth's volcanic activity happens underwater, and you gave me the answer 85%, that would be incorrect because there is more than that. There is 90% that happens in the ocean. Okay, 85 being yes, technically 85%.
Ask me what percent happened volcanic. Ask me the question. Just be like, hey, how much is this? Like, you know,
what percent of volcanic activity happens in the ocean?
I don't know, like 85%.
I don't know, like that's wrong.
And then you look it up and you go, oh, it's 95 and or it's 90. And it's like, oh, yeah, cool. I was close. I was right.
Oh, you were very close. But this wasn't a close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades.
Well, all this right. is horseshoes and hand grenades. Don't you know this the name of the podcast?
No. This is just a fun fact I'll give you. Or do you want me to try and formulate it into a question?
Formulate into a question. I want you to apply yourself here.
All right. Sounds good. The loudest sound ever recorded.
Mantis shrimp.
Was made by an iceberg.
Oh.
In 1997. And the sound that was recorded was named the bloop. And it could have been heard from more than how many miles away? I was going to try and get you to guess
the name. From more than how many?
Yes. If you give me.
So it's more than 1 mile away.
It is more than 1 mile away. How far away could this sound be heard?
More than one, at least.
Come on. You need to give me a close answer.
My final answer is more than one. But because I know that's not what you meant by your phrasing of the question. Say at least 75 miles away. Or more than 75 miles away?
It's actually more than 3,000.
Oh, wow.
More than 3,000 miles away. That's impressive. Wild.
Yeah.
That's considering the Mariana Trench is only 7 miles deep.
I think it's only about 1,000 miles from us to California.
Holy moly. So, yeah, it's like the sound that could have been heard around the world. That's my quiz. Sorry, it wasn't insanely great.
I liked it.
Some of the questions were. Let's see here. I think if I would have had a little bit more time to prepare, I think it would have been great.
It is
two. I technically had all morning to prepare.
It is 2,480 miles away.
Oh, wow. To California? Los
Angeles. Yeah. To Los Angeles. It also says that it would only take a day and a half to drive there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we used to drive to Colorado. I know Colorado's quite a bit over, but it would take us a day to get about halfway across the country, and then it was just like the rest of the day we'd arrive in the evening of the next day. Yeah, it's crazy how fast imagine how fast you could get, like, in Europe. If you're in France, you could within like 2 hours you could be in Spain.
Right. And then that's why like a lot of people, like Europeans, they're like, yeah, I'm gonna go visit South Carolina and then pop over to Texas and then probably head up to Ohio. And it's like, you're here for 2 days. That's not gonna happen.
That'd be nice.
It takes 7 hours to get from Pittsburgh to Philadelphia.
That's insane. I wish that I could like that. That's one of the superpowers I like really, really wish I had, was teleportation. So I could just like show up wherever I wanted, whenever I wanted, and it wouldn't take an hour and a half to get to your house. I could just be like, boom.
Like fast travel would be so nice. It'd be so insane. First of all, I wouldn't have to spend money on gas. And second of all, like, I could actually travel. Like,
yeah.
Because then I don't have to worry about, like, $1,000 plane ticket. And I can just go there and, like, see the sights or whatever. But, like,
yeah.
I don't know.
It'd be nice.
A boy could dream.
One day, your great-great-great-great-great-great-granddaughter, Aurora, will be able to fast travel.
In the year 3000.
In the year, yeah.
I took a trip to the year 3000. This song has a multi-platinum.
Everybody bought our 7,000. Set up into the year 3000.
Nothing has changed, yet they live underwater.
You know what? I think they're just trying to get ahead of the curve. I think the billionaires are trying to get ahead of the curve and stuff. I'm sorry, I had to.
At least they have video games down there to keep them occupied.
Logitech controllers. All right.
How badly did I lose that quiz?
By 1 point.
Okay, so pretty decent score.
Yeah.
I'll take it.
What's your topic this week, bud?
My topic this week, if you haven't checked your texts yet.
I did. I saw it. He quickly sent me a text. He sent me a text, and then very quickly afterwards, in all caps, ignore that.
I wanted to type it out in our text so that I had it. Like, I didn't get it. But then you
just, like, subconsciously press send.
Yeah.
Yep. Been there, done that.
I've gotten real into ASMR eye exams on TikTok.
Oh, don't like that.
I don't know why. First of all, this is going to sound very, I don't know how this is going to sound. Men should not be doing ASMR. I don't like it. If a man comes on and they're like, I'm going to be doing your eye exam. It's like, okay.
Or it's like, hi, I'm going to be doing your eye exam. Please enjoy this video.
It's the exact opposite of the tingles I get from, like, when
women feminine, do it.
I think feminine, it's just voices. The feminine voice.
That's fair.
Because there is one person who I believe is non-binary that I really enjoy theirs as well. And they have a more feminine presenting voice. And so it's probably just the deeper register of tones that just ick, full, yeah. Full ick.
Full ick.
Full on, ick, God, no big, cap. On God, big ick. And so there's, like, a variety of different things that they'll do with the eye exams. One big one is, like, shining a light across the screen. It's like, look at my nose, and then follow the light. And then they'll just go back and forth with a light and then up and down. But there's this one creator, and they have, like, little, like, lens colors. I don't know if you ever did tech in high school for plays or anything, but, like, you have lens gels that you put over a light, and it can change the color of the light.
Yeah.
So then she's like, and tell me which one is better. One, and she'll put, like, a green one over, and then, like, or two, and she'll put a yellow one over. And then, like, shine the light and tell me which one is brighter, and, like, things like that. I always watch them. It's only those ones. Like, if it's a hearing exam, it's, like, it's not the right thing. People, like, do actual chiropractic checkups.
Yeah. Oh, it's like getting roped into watching Dr. Pimple Popper. Like, it's something you just can't look away from, which is wild because it's so grotesque.
I don't mind the actual chiropractic checkups where, like, you hear the crackings and everything.
Yeah.
But they're like, we're going to do, like, a quick checkup here. And then they have, like, a metal thing and they just tap it against their body. And, like, you're picking it up. And it's like, you're not doing anything. If you're going to be pretending to be a medical professional, can you at least do something realistic?
Something that actually seems like you're, like, I'm here for help. And if you're sitting there, like, tapping me with, like, a tuning fork or something, I'm going to get my money back.
Right. Like, I pay for insurance for this. Like,
yeah.
And then you can't leave because they're the only doctor in your network, and then you're just stuck there being hit with a tuning fork.
Freaking insurance, my man. I actually, like, I had a rant with my mother all about insurance the other day. I don't want to, you know, get on here again and on my soapbox and stuff, but yeah, I definitely had a fun insurance talk the other day. It's just so dumb. It's so dumb. Sorry.
The week, I think this week, if I'm getting my days correct, this week I'll be going to the doctors for the first time
in like
a year and a half. Because, like, I would go to a clinic every once in a while, but, like, right. I never went to an actual doctor, like, did, like, full checkups with someone. And it was mainly just like, hey, I need you to sign this form. Like, I don't care about anything else. But now it's like, hey, I should probably make sure I'm not dying.
Well, I'm happy for you. I'm glad you're going to the doctor finally.
I'm not, but
My mom was trying to get me to get life insurance, and like I get life insurance, I do, but you have to do it for like terms. Like you have to do it for specific terms. So it would be very expensive. My payments would be very expensive if I did it to like I was 100, for example. They'd be probably less expensive since I'm starting it so young. However, still expensive.
If you have a more dangerous job, though, like even if you just stayed in security work, security guards have a higher risk employment than other people.
That's true. Life insurance sounds good, but like, what if I do it till I'm 65, like retirement age? I've just spent the last 40 years putting money into something, and then it just goes away. It just goes away entirely. I do not see that money. I do not get any money back. I've been paying for 40 years money that now I'm 65. It's gone. It's gone. I mean, they have it.
I mean, either way, you'll never see the money.
Unless I die before that term.
But if you die, then you won't see the money. Your family will see the money.
Yes.
But you physically will never get that return on investment.
That's what I want, is for my family to be well taken care of in the event of my death, rather than having to scrounge up funeral costs.
What would be fun is if the irony of the day before you die at like 65 and a half, or like whatever, like the next day after you turn 65 and your insurance ends,
I die. Oh man, that would be rough. That'd be really rough.
I want to die on my birthday.
Why?
Because then it's like exact.
Like
my 72nd birthday, like I'm exactly 72 years old.
Yeah.
Like, then there's not like a decimal, and it's like, oh, he would have been this many years old.
Actually, you're technically 9 months older right now.
If you go by conception, like it's your birthday because the day you were born.
Yeah, that's true. I have been out of the womb for 72 years exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's wild. That's wild to think, actually. But we've discussed funerals on here. That was one of our greatest episodes, in my opinion. I honestly would probably want it to be even too, because, or like 6 months exactly, like to the day, so that it's like there's half, I'm like half this way and half that way, you know, kind of situation. I'm definitely going out on my own terms. I'm sorry. Like it's what's happening.
Do we want to bring the episode down by talking about what you mean if like euthanasia or?
Nope. Okay. On to my topic.
What's your topic for this week?
So I actually got this topic, actually just about word for word. I'll try and ad lib a little bit, so I'm not just like writing my name on for test. I got this idea from Erin Broadhurst on TikTok. Okay. So in this video, she talks about the song, Hey Soul Sister by Train.
Okay.
And she says, in this song, it is said that your lipstick stains on my left side, I'm sorry, on the front lobe of my left side brain. This indicates that the lipstick stain is not only situated on the frontal lobe of the brain, but also in an area which is left lateralized for function. And the first area which comes to mind in that section of the brain is the Broca's area, which is responsible for fluid speech production. Okay? When someone acquires a lesion in Broca's area, it means that they can no longer produce speech fluently. It is said in order to acquire a lipstick stain on your brain, that indicates some sort of head trauma. Therefore, indicating that the lipstick stain may have led to Broca's aphasia. In conclusion, I, as well as Erin Broadhurst, believe that the lyric Your lipstick stain on the front lobe of my left side brain is just a very funky neuroanatomical way of saying your kisses have left me speechless.
Where's the memory center in the brain?
The memory, I think it's the, isn't it near the back?
Because the next line is your lipstick stains on the left lobe of the front side brain. I knew I wouldn't forget you.
Oh yeah.
Because then I would go and let you blow my mind.
Oh, that's I think it is that area in the back of the brain that looks funky. I don't know. It looks different than the rest.
Memory.
That I can't remember the name of.
Can I spell, please?
Memory.
Memory. I don't even know what that's from.
I don't either. Just started singing.
See. The main parts of the brain that are involved with memory are the amygdala, hippocampus, the cerebellum, and the prefrontal cortex.
Oh, interesting.
And looking at the photo here of a name of the part of the brain, that's all sort of like in the center ish of the brain, and the cerebellum is like the curly part at the bottom.
Yeah, the part I was talking about.
Yeah. But it could technically be in the front. Part of it is in the frontal lobe.
Yeah. Okay, so the prefrontal cortex is involved in the storage of short-term memories.
Yeah.
The cerebellum is involved in the storage of procedural memories. The hippocampus is a pivotal role in the formation of new long-term semantic and episodic memories. And the amygdala is in the formation of new emotional memories. Holy moly. Everything's memories.
So the amygdala and the hippocampus are probably the most common or the most likely parts to be affected by the lesion. So not only would it have to be on the front left, the kiss would have to be big enough to basically come down to where about the ear is. And so this woman gave this guy so many forehead kisses, it permanently affected his memory. And well, what did you say it was? It was
Broca's aphasia, or
yeah, like the conclusion. What was the conclusion again?
Oh yeah. It's just a funky way of saying your kisses have left me speechless.
The kisses have affected the brain so much, he cannot forget about her, and he can no longer speak. This woman kissed his forehead with such force, she has given him irreversible brain damage.
Kisses.
In a sense, she kissed him with the force of getting hit by a train.
Boom.
I don't even know if that was train. I think that's, is that Plain White Tees?
No, train is the band.
It is? Yes.
Yeah. I really love forehead kisses. I don't know if you know this about me. I really love forehead kisses.
I know you love forehead kisses.
Mia gives me forehead kisses all the time, and I love it so much.
I also give you forehead kisses.
I'm a big forehead kiss kind of person. I give a lot of forehead kisses too. I need to be careful just to not do any, you know, problems in the brain. I don't want to mess that up.
I remember you gave me a forehead kiss once in front of everyone, and they just looked at us like we were weird, and it was like, what? And then they all just remembered who we were and then just went about their day.
Yeah. They didn't care anymore. We've done a lot of weird stuff.
It's only weird if you don't know us.
No, it's still quite weird. It's not out of character. It is weird.
Semantics.
At one point, we stood in an elevator nose to nose. Like, we were touching noses. That's how close we were. We just stood nose to nose, and that's it. The whole time we were in the elevator.
It wasn't a long elevator ride.
No, it wasn't. But it made everybody else in the elevator uncomfortable.
In fairness, that's another thing I got from the Impractical Jokers. But I do enjoy how it makes other people uncomfortable.
We get a lot of our physical bits from Impractical Jokers, I think. I love Impractical Jokers.
There are a few bits that I have that are my own.
Yeah.
One bit I love doing, and this is one of the only bits that my brother really finds funny that I do, is whenever we're walking past someone and they're clearly not a doctor. Like, I did this once when we were going into a Panic at the Disco concert, and we passed the cop, high-vis jacket, like, hat, everything. He went right this way, and I go, doctor? As we went past.
That guy, as you passed him, was like, how did they know I got my doctorate? It's like that the episode at the very end of Avatar The Last Airbender, where they all gather in. Oh, he remembered my birthday. I love bits like that. Those are so funny.
I always feel bad for that dude. No matter how many times I watch that episode, it's like,
yeah,
oh, that guy just like had one of the best moments of his life, and then dropped out of a blimp into the ocean.
I mean, most of the Fire Nation, they're essentially Nazis. So, like, I don't have that much empathy for him, but
good soldiers follow orders.
That's a Nazi phrase.
No, it's a clone trooper phrase.
I'm aware when they were brainwashed into following Order 66.
Good soldiers follow orders.
It was not a good thing that they followed those orders blindly.
Depends on what side of the argument you're on.
The good side of the argument, which...
Are you telling me the Jedi didn't have their faults?
Oh, absolutely not. They had so many faults. They were indirectly the cause of all of this. However, it was a bad thing that the clone troopers followed Order 66.
Sure. But if you look at it from an outside perspective, you have a religious organization that formed a military complex and started imposing what they believed was the correct way to live on the entire galaxy. The Jedi basically did the space crusades, and then the Nazis came about and were like, hey, no.
They were, in all technicalities, they were forced into the war. They didn't want to be in the war. They were forced into the war. But regardless, I don't have an outside perspective. I have an inside perspective because I've seen the movies, and the show, and just about every other thing.
Oh, you've seen the war crimes that those religious fanatics did?
Yes, and I've also seen the Empire and how they are evil.
Name one evil thing that they've done.
Destroyed planets with the Death Star.
Planet.
It doesn't matter. The First Order, which is a direct cause of the Empire, a direct evolution of the Empire, destroyed many planets.
Yes. I will fully say that the First Order is very Nazi-esque.
Yes.
If anything, the First Order is World War II, the Empire is World War I.
I can see that. Yep. Ooh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
That's wild.
Thank you for listening to this week's episode of the Garlic Voice Podcast. If you would like to follow us on TikTok and Instagram for more and from us and some updates about when things are out. If you also, if you got to stop, you're throwing me off. you could also listen to our D&D podcast called TGB One Shots.
It's good.
I'm Let me just remember the schedule. Yeah, we're doing a Spelljammer campaign right now.
Yeah.
And if you can find out the secret connection between me and Matt, let us know in the comments what you think the theory is.
Oh yeah.
If you would like to support us on Patreon, you can. The lowest tier is $3 a month, and I promise you that helps us more than you can know. And if you'd like to watch video versions of the podcast, you can find those at youtube.com/@thegarlicboys. Matt, supplementary mom report for this week.
Man, you're hitting me up way too soon. Supplementary mom report. Does she have kids? I don't know if she ever has kids.
What do you mean?
Ash's mom. Supplementary mom report. Ash's mom. You're great.
Does Ash's mom have kids?
No. I was thinking of someone else. Ash's mom. You're great. You're cool.
Supplementary mom report from me. The Xenomorph from Alien.
Totally. Yeah, she was a great mom. Woo! Definitely didn't kill a lot of people.
To protect her kids.
Right. And she...
Would you like me to pick a different mom, Matt?
No. It's good. It's good. It's good. It's good mom. Good mom.
What are your final thoughts?
I don't have any, because my lobe of my brain has been affected by your kisses.
Well, thank you for listening, and as always, remember to
stay garlicky. Oh boy.